be triggered by that girl you most admire. When Mel was in school, there was a girl who sat next to me who had a mole I wanted to grab. It was weeks before I finally gave in. Pick up a book on personal hygiene. Stop writing to Mel. Go see a doctor. But Mel just doesn't get paid enough to think about heinies, much less answer letters from one. And then again, I could be wrong. They call me Mel.
Okay, now, do you get the feeling there's something going on here today that we don't know about? Because I didn't hear like five words of that, which I heard the beginning, which I thought was kind of cute, but I didn't hear any of the rest of it. And Denenberg is over here potchking around with copy while we're on the air.
Hi, Neil.
Is there any special reason for this? And also, I've got an insipid, an idiotic thing here from Disney about my roast. I'm not doing any roast, okay?
The roast.
He comes up with these ridiculous ideas.
Oh, when is
Remember
it?
We were going to do the show, like, even if we can't take the show to Disney, to MGM or somewhere exciting, we were going to do it out in the parking lot.
Oh,
what is this?
That.
This is the middle of May? And we haven't done 1 second of the show outside of this little claustrophobic room, have we? Or did I miss something? Not 1 second. And he just insists he's going to continue complicating my life with this hazirai. I'm not interested in roasts and ego trips, okay? To me, there's nothing more nauseating than that. Oh, God, does that turn me off.
When is it?
Oh, it ain't going to happen. You know, I didn't have the heart to tell him because he gave me this cockamamie idea a couple of months ago, and I looked at him and I smiled and I said, well, you know, way down the road. Now he's leaving me notes. He's talking to people about this. This man, honest to God, is just exasperating, okay? Like yesterday, he comes in here after getting his car stolen at the airport, and the first thing he does, the only thing he does, is drop that Cubs T-shirt on the table. Now, of all the days, they just had lost five in a row, which, thank goodness, we ended yesterday. And, well, I'm going to tell you, if you want information on any team except the Yankees, don't listen to sports talk. I can't wait to get Hank in here Thursday, although he's not the guiltiest party. Joe, yeah, I listened to sports talk in the car last night. I was going to the store. And they drone on and on about the Yankees this and the Yankees that. Then the Yankees lose the game anyway, like usual. I wanted to find out what happened to Bilecki. He had to leave the game in the seventh inning. His arm tightened up. I wanted to find if there was any information about that. Nothing. Then there was a thing about Rick Sutcliffe getting cortisone shot in his back. He's going to miss his turn tomorrow. Did we have anything about that? Maybe. I didn't hear it. It may have been on there. I missed it.
Is Joe from New York?
No. I don't know where Joe is from. Hunger, isn't he? I mean, Joe's a nice guy. A nice kid. But very narrow in scope, I would say. Very, very narrow in scope. There's a lot of information. I mean, it's not just the Cubs. There are 24 other teams besides the Yankees and the Cubs, right? And there are fans out there of all of them. I'm sure there even somebody wants to hear about Seattle. Well, maybe not. Anyway, it's 9 minutes past 10. I must say that yesterday was one of the worst shows in the history of this program.
Not us.
Not us.
No, we were fine.
I was thinking about it, not at length, because I don't. When I leave here, basically, it's history. But I was just thinking, I can't think of one good call in 4 hours yesterday. Not one.
Paul Harvey Jr.
No. No, one of his worst. I mean, for him, saying one of his worst, that's saying a lot. He was an idiot yesterday. He had nothing to say.
No one did.
I can't think of one
person that anything to
decent
say.
Call.
Can
you?
One.
No.
No?
No.
Not one?
Oh, no. They were boring, and their voices all had that old IOD sound to them, you know?
I like the girl who called up the lightning round and calls you a dork.
I'm not talking. Okay. Even the lightning round was boring yesterday. We didn't even have one dying over here. That's how bad
true.
It was yesterday.
That's true, but we did have the
doctor must have had a patient. Maybe he was in surgery. Where are your priorities, Doc, okay? I can just see him handing the scalpel over to somebody else during the middle of the operation. Oh, it's time for the lightning round. Would you take over, please?
Probably not.
And
no
rushing
joke.
Over to the payphone with his blood-soaked rubber gloves on, you know? Speaking of blood-soaked rubber gloves, Steve has an unusual topic on his show today.
Oh, my. Oh, my God.
By the way, Pizza Loft is bringing food Thursday, so Hank, you know, Hank is, like, kind of trying to orchestrate the whole thing. Hank, you're a wonderful guy, but we don't need any help in getting food in here. We've been very, very successful. As a matter of fact, Peppers, which is, we heard last week, was going to bring food, and they got shut out because we had all these other people lined up ahead of them. Is a sponsor. I didn't know that. I heard him on Sports Talk last night. It's a Mexican restaurant. It's here on the 79th Street Causeway somewhere. And maybe someday they'll bring some food over to us, even though they're on Sports Talk.
Oh, yeah.
Peppers. Sounds pretty interesting. like some real spicy Mexican food. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking of going to Mexico for my vacation now. Why is there this long, long silence? Well, look at Stan, milked months out of his Mexican vacation.
He's still talking about it.
Yeah, he still does shows on his trip to Mexico, that villa, and how he couldn't breathe in that. Was it Stan?
He did months on
He went
Mexico.
Into that place and he couldn't breathe?
Yeah.
In the bar?
Yeah.
And they were all going... Anyway, I started to say before I interrupted myself, Steve has a very unusual topic today. It's going to be another abortion on WIOD. Well, that's what it says. It's a reaction to Roe v. Wade, the NBC TV movie which aired last night, which somehow I missed. I just didn't get it, you know.
I missed it, too.
And the guest today, and I hope you're holding on to your seat when I tell you this. The guest today includes Susan Glickman, pro-choice liberal, Melissa Dunn, pro-choice conservative, whatever the hell that means. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, again. Can we have a little drum roll for
Please.
This?
Please.
Frankly, my dear, I don't give a damn.
No, that's not what we want. I'm just stalling for time. I don't think the drum roll is in here anymore. Well, it may be. It may take us till about 11 o'clock to find it. Now, this guest deserves a drum roll. Make no mistake about this. This is something really unusual and special on the Kane Show, and I can't find the drum roll. Well, we'll have to do without. The other guest is the Reverend Pat Mahoney of Florida Rescue, who's making his 88th appearance this week, and it's only Tuesday. So don't forget, it's the Reverend Pat Mahoney Show with special guest Steve Kane this afternoon at 2. That's funny. Steve's guesting 2 days in a row. He's on the Ellis Rubin Show yesterday. I only heard about 2 minutes of that. It's always interesting to me because if I only catch a couple of minutes of certain shows, must be my luck. Because the Cub game had ended and I got in the car to go to the store. And just as I turned the radio on, they were saying something about the fact that I had mentioned Steve was going to be a guest on the Ellis Rubin Show, and Ellis, of course, being a big fan of mine, made some comment that must have been a shot or something like that. Yeah, it was a shot, Ellis, okay? It was a real shot. Okay, we owe a little apology here, not a big one, just a little one, to Joe Zagacki, who just came racing into the room during the break and said,
I'm a Cub fan and a Bud man, and I trust you are, too.
Now, he evidently spent a few minutes at the beginning of the show on the Cubs yesterday, alleged, on Sports Talk, okay? That's what he said. I didn't hear it. All I ever hear is about the stinking Yankees. It's all, although tonight they got Lou Gorman, the GM of the Boston Red Sox, so at least, thank goodness, we'll get to hear something a little bit different instead about those stinking Yankees. Boy, not only are the Yankees bad, but their broadcasts, those are really some of the all-time worst in history. John Sterling, I mean, when you can't make the cut with the Braves, okay, when you're like the odd man out with the Braves, does that tell you something?
Oh, is this over?
No, it's not over, okay? It's not over. And you're not getting paid to read the newspaper, okay? They're paying you to cackle.
Waiting.
Boy, all of a sudden he's back to this again now. He's pouting again.
No, I'm not pouting.
Okay, here's my pick. I'm sure Phil Saltzman is getting his voice warmed up. We got a first race pick today. I'm not monkeying around anymore. We got Katie's Boo with Gonzalez in the first race. And I can't believe you passed over a horse that you just love, Gentle Tim, in the sixth.
I'm no dummy.
And you're going with Stevie's Doctor in the fifth race. Seems like almost all your horses are with Chavez, and mine are all with Gonzalez.
Coincidence.
There are no coincidences. Well, Mike has done very well for me, that's all I can say. Chavez, of course, has a lot more winners, but it's a question of picking which ones they are. So anyway, the Cubs won 4-0 yesterday, and Bilecki pitched another great game, and Sutcliffe is missing a turn, and we had this kid. It's really great when you bring up a kid who's never played for you before. A kid, he's 30 years old, and his name is McClendon. And you know how I said to myself I'd remember the name? Because that's a radio name, Gordon McClendon. And this guy looks like he ought to be in radio, not in baseball, because he's like short and stocky. He like waddles. In fact, they hit a fly ball to left field, and he waddled back and fell on his ass, and it went over his head for a double. But anyway, that's all of baseball for today, because somebody we know is getting real surly and just going through a whole routine, reading the paper, and getting all bent out of shape, and we can't discuss this, and we can't talk about anything he cares about.
I want to ask you
about
something.
And we can't talk about upstate New York, and we can't talk about downstate New York, and we can't talk about Detroit, and we can't talk about anything Neil's interested in, because we want to talk about Lakeland.
Are you going to be okay?
No, I don't think so. I'm in a real... I don't know what happened. I was in a great mood. I came in and I saw this idiotic note from Disney about my roast.
Oh.
We're not doing a roast, okay? The only roast we do is in the oven. God almighty, just... Can't you send him away again for a few days? Go in there and tell him that he's got some emergency in Chicago, that he's got... That the Cubs need him up there or something. They need him to pitch tomorrow because Sutcliffe's missing a turn. Oh, man. He just, you know, it wasn't it the same everywhere I've ever been? It's always the same. When the management people are gone, everything is smooth and everything is calm and peaceful and there are no little nudgy-dicky things that come along. When any of the management people are even in town, much less in the building, there always are these little inane, stupid like this. Okay, great. Good luck to you. Right in the circular file, the roast. Roast this, okay? 20 minutes past 10 at WIOD. We may or may not take any calls today. The audience may be burnt out, the callers. We may need to give them a rest. In fact, we may do the lightning round. Just us.
Well, I'm kind of a mess today because of...
Oh, by the way, attorney Barry Silver will also be on this contrived panel on the Cain Show today at 4 p.m. to make it a true abortion. And, God, it's just... You know, this is so simple. It's another one of these things where people just won't leave other people alone. Okay. And I love the way they, and it's just shocking to me the way Steve is jumping into bed, so to speak, with people like Pat Mahoney, with these virulent right-wingers, okay? Because I guess his true leanings are now rising to the surface. It's intolerance, that's what it is. And they can make all these excuses. Oh, it's a baby, it's a child, and it's got two arms, and it's got two legs. And you know, that's like arguing for tadpole rights, okay? In a world that's just overrun with unwanted babies, that's got more people that we can deal with. Let me ask you this question. Do we need more people in the world or fewer? Is that a difficult question? Do we need more or fewer people to make the quality of life meaningful? And, of course, the Pope and the Catholic Church for centuries have been hocking a chinic about, oh, you got to use, you know, I Got Rhythm is their theme song. And in the meantime, they're overpopulating the whole world, which is like forced misery, okay? Like all of Latin America, we got all these people streaming across the border in Texas. Why? Because they're populating, they're reproducing like rabbits down there, okay? But so we got to have more babies. Because Steve wants to adopt one. Would somebody give Steve and Lori a baby so they can get off this thing already? Jeez.
I've decided that's a conscience. My man Lori's going to sit in and we're going to get arrested and we're going to get a lot of publicity and it's going to be great. And then Ellis Rubin can defend us and then he can be on the show again for five times.
Oh, my God. So anyway, it's all your reaction. Now, everybody who did not see the movie last night, we don't want to talk to these idiots anyway. Okay, let's just clear the lines and use them for... Okay, anybody who did not see the movie, let's see a little show on the phone here. If you did not see Roe v. Wade on NBC last night, okay? Okay, there's one. I guess everybody saw the movie.
I guess.
There's two. Three. Nobody in Dade saw the movie, okay? No, nobody in Palm Beach saw the movie. That's four. Pretty slow. Pretty slow in Broward and in Boca. So I guess there's only four people in the whole audience who didn't see the movie. It's going to be a hot show, Steve. Everybody did their homework and watched that movie. Look at that. There's not one line in Broward County flashing.
Yeah, they all...
This is the slowest response I have ever seen in my life. Everybody in this... All right, now we'll show you something, okay, to show you how dumb this audience is. Okay, we cleared those lines. Everybody who did see the movie last night, now let's... Your turn to call in. Everybody who saw Roe versus Wade, there's two in Dade. Two in Dade.
A little passive, maybe. I don't know.
Now, you notice Broward? Neither one. Broward is not participating. All right, now let's clear... Too late. Clear those. All right, now those of you who don't care, who don't give a good flying leap either way about Roe versus Wade and the movie and abortion... Let's see those lines light up, okay? Here's two in Dade, one in Palm Beach.
Does this tell you anything?
Did you ever have the feeling that you were talking to yourself?
Yeah.
It started again yesterday. We went through that. No. We had this after Easter, and then we had that lull, and then all of a sudden everything was going along fine, and now it's like, look at that, there's three lines flashing. Even the people who don't give a damn won't call.
Does that tell you anything?
Wow. Are the Broward lines working?
Wow.
Oh, they're not working.
They're not working.
Oh, listen to this. Here I'm blaming the audience, okay?
The lines aren't working.
Look at that. Boca's not working. Broward is all screwed up. What the hell is going on here today? What, it's in here? Oh, don't give me that stuff. All right, let's... One moment, please. No, it's not me. The line is screwed up. How the hell could the board make that noise? Oh, man, a regular rocket scientist in there. It's my fault. It's the lines are all screwed up. And I'm sitting here, and my whole show is being governed because the lines don't work again. Oh, man, this place... You talk about an insane asylum, okay? If there are any of those of you out there who think you need to be in a padded cell, in a rubber room, just come on down the 79th Street Causeway. You'll be right at home, okay? Right at home. Anyway, guess what night it is? It's Tuesday. Yeah, those lines are really doing it, boy, Gary. They're really doing it. This is a disaster. This is a technical disgrace, this place, okay? And, of course, remember how quickly we got that line fixed last time? It only took us a week to get one line fixed last time. Okay, those are my sentiments. 1029 at WIOD, the home of technical astonishment. It just never ceases to amaze me. Every day is like a whole new... Didn't I always say that? That when you work in this market, every morning, you could have a 98 share. Every day when you come in, it's like the first day that you've been on the air. Because you never know if anything is going to work. You never know if these morons are going to call. You never know what mood they're going to be in. It's like... And you never know what kind of idiotic memos you're going to get from management.
Oh.
About my roast. Roast this, okay?
Oh, where's that going to be at?
Out in the parking lot. Well, I guess this is it, huh?
I'm a Cub fan and a Bud fan, and I trust you are too.
Oh. That was shocking.
Just like the old Big Ape.
Yeah, we're going to punish the audience by playing Gary Lewis and the Playboy records. All right, listen to this.
Nothing.
Oh, they did they?
They're working on it. They're working on it.
Wait a minute, you hear that?
Nothing.
No, there's a good hum on there.
Mm-mm.
You don't hear that?
Oh, there. Yeah, I can hear it now. Real low.
Okay, so half of the lines are out. I had a feeling that there was something amiss, as they say.
You never know.
Either that or Sandy may have been doing an abortion. Upstage old Steve, huh? I don't know what we're going to do with him. You know, he just, he's out of control. He really is out of control. I can see now why Sharon just has fits. Because, boy, once he gets something in his mind... once he gets something in his mind, there is no reasoning with him. He's just going to plot ahead... And nobody is going to stop him, you know, no matter how idiotic it may be and no matter how repetitive it is. He's just going to bash it down your throat. But that's okay. We don't want to interfere, do we?
Do we?
Sure we do. We're trying to save him from himself, just like he's trying to save all these unborn babies. Once these people are born, to hell with them, okay? Like, we got all these people living or out there in the streets... And all these people are living in abject poverty, and people who are with the distended bellies and everything. And we don't like watching that because it makes us uncomfortable, okay? So to hell with that. We'd like to pretend none of that exists. Just keep women as baby manufacturers, basically. I think really deep-seated it's part of Steve's sexist psyche. Part of his, you know, that a woman is supposed to be a baby-making machine.
Oh.
And that she somehow has this responsibility to keep bearing children until she just can't bear no more, so to speak. So anyway, we've got a real exciting day here already, and we just sat down, so it looks like it's going to really be good. I got a lot of good music here, though.
Now, speaking of excitement, I was driving home from work yesterday, and I was driving in the rain on the Dauphin Expressway. Now, when it's a beautiful, sunny, perfect day, the Dauphin Expressway doesn't move. Can you imagine what it was like yesterday in the rain? So anyway, I saw this bumper sticker.
You think this song might be appropriate? She's come undone.
It was a Roby...
That's the song they sing at the 103.5, isn't it?
a Roby Young Jerry Powers WVCG bumper sticker.
Not for me.
Can you believe that?
Not for me, okay?
Really livened up the trip home. You know what I mean?
Yeah. 10:33 on All Schmutz Radio. Now let's talk about that roast. Why is it I get the feeling that we just can't get it together here? Is there some special reason I get that feeling that this place just can't get their act together? And have you noticed Sharon is on vacation?
Yeah.
Now, if there's anybody who has any doubt, Sharon is like the catalyst for this entire building. And if you had any doubt to that, when she was out sick, and now that she's on vacation, this place is like a morgue. Have you noticed?
Did you see the Hot Topics blackboard?
Oh, no, I don't go in there.
It says on vacation.
The blackboard's on vacation,
there's
too.
There's no topics on that board. It says on
but
vacation.
Seriously, she's like the spark plug. She's about the only lively thing in the building that, like, keeps running around trying to keep these people awake and on their toes. And now that she's on vacation, it's like you can just kind of lay back and... It's like a morgue in this place. You look up and down the halls, there's nobody there, and they're just death.
Yeah, remember when I went out
clouds
yesterday?
Clouds of death
to
hanging
look for
over
people?
The building, and nobody there.
Nope,
yeah, that's
on.
True. We had lunch yesterday. Not that Sharon eats a lot, because she's a pretty tiny little gal, but she at least gets everybody else going.
Yeah.
She motivates them.
Yeah.
She ought to be on the... Well, I wouldn't say that. That would be evil. I was going to say she ought to be at the motivation station, but she doesn't deserve that. Anyway, it's 10:34 at WIOD. We're just going to do a lot of spots today, and... you know.
Mess around
a little bit. Phil will be calling in the call of the first race.
Oh, good.
And Sunday Silence is working out today, and I hope that Joe keeps his eye peeled on the wire so we find out that if he comes out of the workout okay, he may actually run in the Preakness on Saturday. Dave Johnson's going to be calling us on Friday. Hank will be here Thursday, touting, of course, as always, and eating up a storm. Pizza Loft is going to be here with food.
Despite what he thinks.
Well, yeah, see, I don't understand that, Hank. I mean, I grant you he works here, but, you know, we can take care of the food. We can cater any... There's no lunch too big or too small for us to cater, as we discovered yesterday.
Yeah, boy, is that the truth.
I mean, Wings Plus brought enough food for... In fact, Gorbachev and Deng Xiaoping together could have fed all of their troops.
Yeah. We could have almost fed seven, almost, you know.
Well, now you're really getting carried away.
I know.
10:35 at WIOD. This is going to be some week. I can see that already. With the calls yesterday and with our phone today, it's going to be some big week. Broward screwed up. Boca screwed up. So we got a little Judas Priest for it. I hope this fades, huh? Boy, it would be bad.
Slowly.
It's cold. I would feel like I was at RMS. There's nothing worse than talking over the ending of a record that ends cold like they do on RMF. Anyway, it's 10:42 on All Hit Radio I-61. Hey, listen, we got the phones are screwed up, and I'm not going to do a show with only 17 lines, man. We got to have at least 100 lines to do a show, don't we? Huh? Let's crank them out and really piss them off over next door at GTR.
Piss off your neighbors?
Piss off those neighbors right next door at GTR, right? Which doesn't take a lot. They're a little thin-skinned, aren't they?
A little
uptight, out of sight.
You need cooling. Baby, I'm not cooling.
.47 at WID. You know what really, really frosted my can?
Mm-mm.
Sandy already played that this morning. Anyway, Peppers is going to be sending food at noon today. See that? See, Hank, if you're listening, which I doubt, but if you were, we don't need you catering food in here from places that aren't even sponsors, okay? We like to bring, you know, food in from people who are spending a few bucks to get a little plug there. And Peppers, which I heard on Sports Talk myself, mm-hmm. Mexican, right around the corner here. I can't wait for that. They're bringing food at noon. That ought to be great.
Good.
We got the Who and Tommy. We got the whole thing here. I got it in the mail yesterday. May not be a bad idea after all. And we have a rumor that Steve Stansel is banging his head against the door next door at GTR because we're playing better music than they are this morning, okay? Although that wouldn't be hard, would it? Yeah.
I have one thing I need to mention here.
No, they're okay.
Before
they're
you
right.
move
Not
along.
Not great, because FM... Juan Carlos Cotex called me at home yesterday from the Herald, and he's writing this piece about FM radio and music radio here, and we went on at great length, and he just doesn't seem to want to... Well, I guess he does, but it's a bitter pill to swallow, as they say at Zeta, a bitter pill.
What?
That FM radio in this market sucks. The music is terrible. It is. It's awful.
Yeah. Sure.
You can keep punching around. See, now most newer cars have got 12 FM presets. You've got two groups of six, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't do any good. It's hard enough to fill up six, much less 12.
Yeah, I have trouble with six.
Oh, yeah.
Big trouble. Anyway, this is major news in your house and my house, and I just wanted to pass this on so everybody knew. Tonight on David Letterman on TV,
yeah,
Norm Abram, who, of course, as everybody knows, is the master carpenter from this old house.
Dave had a repeat last night, and it was another Howard Stern appearance where Howard was trying to hawk that stupid videotape.
Still? That negligee?
The negligee and the panty party or whatever it was. Howard is so. He did have one great line, though, about Ed Koch. He said he was in Hollywood Squares, and they asked him which mayor makes the most money. He said he knows it can't be Ed Koch because he didn't have to make a lot of money because he doesn't date. Wow. What a mess. Lord Almighty, feel my temperature rising. Nylons, what is that, on 8? Hello?
Hey, Neil, what's happening?
Well, our phones are out of order, otherwise we'd be happy to talk to you. It's 4 minutes till... Well, no, we're not going to talk to people with just 20 or 30 stinking lines working. We want 100. Wouldn't it be great to have 100 lines and none of them lit?
Wouldn't like
that
a
be
nightmare.
Something? Yeah, that guy thinks because... See, I'm not impressed by all these douchebags that call them from the Cayman Islands. Like the guy yesterday who was supposedly from Pittsburgh, and it turned out to be the same jerk, Mr. Tremolo. Remember the Trembler? He was my favorite call of the day.
Was that
get
it?
A radio show! Get a radio show! Boy, I'm telling you, this town... I want to tell you something seriously, okay? This place is... I think we all died and went to hell. I really do.
Oh...
Is that possible? I mean, the weather, I love the weather. And what really pisses me off is these people that bitch about, it's so humid. It's so, well, if it's so humid, go inside. Every place is air-conditioned. Or go in your car and take a nice ride, okay, with your air-conditioning. Don't stop bitching about the weather. The weather's the only thing we got here. We got a bunch of Yahoo hayseed Neanderthals who run these towns, who've kept this in the dark ages. Even, you know, you go up to Orlando, it's a real eye-opener. Because there are a bunch of yokel Yahoo hayseeds up there, too, but they're making money.
No kidding. No,
and they got
kidding.
Every day, not just every week or every month, but every day is another major thing. You know what I'm saying? Like all year round. They don't have, for example, I was driving to work today and I noticed the sign, the Hollywood Dog Track, it said opens December 26th, the day after Christmas. And I was thinking, isn't that a funny coincidence? The day after Christmas until Easter, that's the season here, which is really just a couple of months, basically, 3 months. And the rest of the year, it's like we're supposed to expect to be in kind of our death mode, you know?
Do you really think
that... In
fact,
I was in a restaurant the other day, and on the dessert menu, they had pie a la death mode.
Do you really think people are driving down here from up north, and they're not going further south than Orlando?
We have a little Depeche Mode, by the way, coming up in the next hour. What?
Do you think, actually, it's possible that tourists coming down here aren't going further south than Orlando? Is that possible?
They're going south, like to Lake Buena Vista. That's south. But anyway, it's just, it's really sad. It's tragic. And you people, you just sit back and you accept, well, this is just the way it is. And we got old Steve Clark there and Bob Cox. And we're all, you know, sitting around the table picking our noses. And it just, this is sad. I kept thinking, we could have had this. Remember Interama?
Of course.
Which is like a big sewer now. I mean, it's like a big empty parking lot with mud. And we could have had Disney World here, but oh, no, we didn't want that Walt Disney, man, because next thing you know, he'll be freezing himself, and we'll have to have a big refrigerator. We just can't handle this, okay? We don't want the prosperity.
Can you imagine if that was...
Everything here is like Death Valley days, and Pompano closed up. And then I see the committee up in Tallahassee. They voted down off-track betting.
Oh, good.
The first shot around. You know, they always have to postpone the inevitable. And what are all these Yahoos screaming about? Oh, they ought to redraw that lotto drawing from Saturday. It wasn't on TV. I think it's fixed. You know, you people are, first of all, if you're playing the damn lottery, you got to be a moron to begin with, okay? Why don't you just have a little bonfire and burn the money in your dining room, okay? Take one of those little candles that they have, you know, one of those decorative candles in restaurants, and just burn the money. Have a little celebration instead of buying those stupid lottery tickets. You got to be out of your mind.
Be a lot more fun.
Yeah, you can have a little party with the money, okay? Or better yet, give it to charity. People are starving to death. Oh, that's gambling. Yeah, isn't it amazing how we got all these forms of gambling? We can't have off-track betting, though, because that would corrupt the populace. That's gambling. And then we certainly don't want casinos because that's gambling, and you know how evil gambling. They've always got to postpone the inevitable here until we're starving to death, until we're desperate. Then they finally say, ah, oh, maybe we should have Sunday racing. You know, everybody else has done it for 50 years. Maybe we ought to give it a try now.
I'm Henry Barrow, News Talk Radio 610 WIOD.
News Talk Radio 610 WIOD presents Neil Rogers. To get in touch and talk, call 751-WIOD in Dade, 524-WIOD in Broward, or 655-278-WIOD in the Palm Beaches. Other areas may call collect. The opinions expressed by the host, guests, or callers are not necessarily those of the station. Now, here's Neil Rogers on News Talk Radio 610 WIOD.
Oh, yeah, Ricky. Oh, yeah, Nicky.
Aruba, Jamaica, ooh, I wanna take ya. Bermuda, Bahama, come on,
please. One moment, please.
Key Largo, Montego, baby, why don't we go? Jamaica, off the Florida Keys. There's a place called Kokomo. That's where you wanna go to get away from it all. Bodies in the sand, tropical kisses melting in your hands. We'll be falling in love.
Distinct honor of presenting to you the President of the United States.
Politics is higher taxes. Politics is fewer jobs. Federal regulations. Surely Congress doing drugs. I'll tell you, government is too big.
I know.
Government is too much.
You know.
These are actions we are taking for the public good. We must tie the hands of business. We must tie the hands of crime. We must tie the hands of Boris Yeltsin. This is hard time.
Hard time. Hard time.
Something's gone wrong.
Outrageous.
Hard time.
Hard time.
You know what I'm talking about.
I know.
Hard time.
Hard time.
Doing what I think is right.
Yes.
But in the end, we all pay the price. I'll tell you, unemployment is too high. I've let our country down.
Thank you.
Problem faces crime and
racism.
The Berlin Wall came tumbling down.
The winds of change are with us now.
With communism gone.
Yes.
World hunger.
Crime and politics.
So much to be grateful for.
But we have
heart.
We have
style.
We have
class.
We have
soul.
We have faith in our society.
Yes.
We're a nation
of rock and roll.
I saw Elvis.
Outrageous.
I saw Elvis.
With the nagging
cost of freedom.
With the nagging
cost of health.
With the nagging
threat of nuclear war.
I almost peed myself.
We must move our country forward.
610 WIOD.
Okay, it's 1116 at WIOD. I bet you Sandy didn't play this yet. She did beat us to Led Zeppelin this morning, no question about that.
Well, that's Sandy.
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
This is a temporary
law. They play this on GTR?
They do?
Wow. What does that say? We don't have time to listen to the whole thing. Here we go. Now. Yeah. That, yeah. Just one? Oh, yeah? Oh, Mitch, come on now. That was... Now, who else in the world would even remember that?
Okay,
this
only
man
Mitch.
Is just obsessed. What a sickness.
Mitch.
Wow. That was shocking.
Did you hear me say that on my way home yesterday I saw a Roby Young Jerry Powers WBCG bumper sticker?
That's
serious. What does that tell you?
Okay, it's 11:17 at WID, where we're just having a good time till lunch shows up. Thank you so much, Mitch, for that inane piece of bad music. Wow, they're playing that on GTR, huh?
Yeah.
Butch it up, Bill. That's Spike Wise, boy. He is just really butchering that place, isn't he? Anyway, we do have an open line in Palm Beach. Let's just make sure it's working. It's working. So all eight lines are working, and seven of them are lit. Aren't you excited?
No.
And I should have said this, and I blew it. That poor guy that was on the line before, by accident?
Mm-hmm.
He was the best call in 2 days. And he was only on like through a miracle, okay? Here's a mobile in Miami. Hello.
Hello, Neil.
Yeah.
Stanley Ross is a douchebag.
Who? That's it? Pretty weak. Well, I guess we don't want to expect too much all at once. Stanley who?
So you said seven are lit, huh?
Right as I speak, seven of them are lit. Even Palm Beach is lit up. How do you like that? Isn't that exciting?
Now, that wasn't an example. We just had a...
Well, he was a mobile.
Okay.
Okay. Right. No more mobiles today. We're not talking any more mobile phones. If they say they're calling on a mobile phone, hang up on them. Sick and tired of these pseudo-intellectual idiots. You notice how more and more of the mobile calls are idiots?
Yeah. No question.
Morons.
Yeah.
Plantation, hello.
Is this the Speak to the Stars of L.A. Law hotline?
Yeah, go ahead, sir. Real quick. Make it real snappy. What do you want?
No, that was it.
Okay, see ya. One of your morons, okay?
Don't...
L.A. Law.
Come on.
Get away already. Nobody watches L.A.
Oh,
Law.
Oh, no, no one. Mm-mm.
They don't.
Mm-mm. No, nobody.
It's just like the people who claim to watch Nightline. Okay?
It is not
everybody.
The
and don't
same.
Forget, this week, 9 to 11, Thursday night on CBS.
We have a
special two-hour edition of Knott's Landing.
Thursday night from 10 to 11, we have the final L.A. Law
Nobody cares
episode.
About that. That's why we're getting an hour head start. That's the only way we can compete. Okay, there's an opening in Broward if you move real fast. I don't even watch Knott's Landing anymore, okay? It is so tedious and so ponderous and so... You know, actually, when you sit right down and stop and think about it, it's like any of these soap operas. If you had the trauma in your life that these people have every stinking day, I mean, it just never stops, and people are murdering each other, and people are psychotic, and just kind of like around here. You know?
Yeah, you don't
you
need more of that.
You couldn't deal with it. You
no.
couldn't deal with it. Boca, hello.
Hey, Neil Bird.
And none of these people even has a shrink. That's the amazing part. Am I right?
You're absolutely right. I don't watch either of the shows.
Boy, they both suck. I'm going to watch, what's his name, the home handyman there with the on the PBS, you know.
Oh,
Bob Vila.
Bob Vila. Bob Vila, yeah.
And his farewell show.
Listen, I have a Bruce Williams spy report.
You know on a Tuesday, no less. Hey, it really fits in. It's Tuesday.
You know, I was driving up to Orlando, and there was nothing on the radio at night, so I just slipped.
No, you're wrong about that. Go ahead.
And you think your calls are bad. You should hear his call. He had two calls. One, was about this guy who was going to invest in oil and gas in West Virginia,
mm-hmm.
and was going to take out a second mortgage on his home.
Yeah.
And the other call was about this lady who had old silverware and wanted to know the best place to trade it in.
Oh, she should call Sandy. Sandy can help her out with that when she's got the collectibles guy on.
And the guy is on there touting his show like he's actually going to get into someone's soul and help them.
Yeah.
And those were the two calls I listened to.
Uh-huh.
They were ridiculous.
Well, it's a hell of a show, I'll tell you that. Just open up that pot and put any crap on that you want. Speaking of that, Bush Bing Bang tonight from 8 till 9:35 Yankee baseball time.
He was the worst.
Even worse than Bush Bing Bang?
I don't listen to that guy either.
Nobody else does either. I saw the book.
His promo is about the most exciting thing.
Uh-huh.
But you know, at the end of the promo, he goes, let's do it, da-da-da-da-da-da. What is that?
Oh, he does that all the time. He thinks he's funny, and he's not. He's just embarrassing, and he'll go do 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 do.
Yeah,
he makes all these little stupid sounds. He's like, it's like the march of the right wing brigade or something. I don't know what his story is.
If these guys are national,
yeah, what does that tell you?
You could be the king.
The king and
I mean, the king, the queen, the court, and everything.
Mm-hmm. Well, I got part of that knocked already.
Because these guys suck.
Yeah. I know.
I thought, here we go. I'm driving up. I'm finally going to listen to this guy's national. And he talks like he's going to touch everyone's heart.
Well, don't forget, Ira Fistula was national, too. He used to be on overnights at INZ, Ira Fistula.
I never heard him.
Oh, God. He makes Bruce Williams sound like the answer man.
And then he was
pathetic.
Then they had this guy on afterwards that talks about personal problems.
Mm-hmm.
Another national guy, part of Bruce Williams' show.
Yeah, TalkNet.
Yeah, TalkNet. That's it. They were just pathetic. One more thing. I was in Sun Bank, and Life has a new promotional. You know, WLYF?
Yeah.
They have a poster. Life, the music, the living
room. Well, that's for people who are posters, okay? People who are like postcard posters.
They have a poster of one of these guys from the radio station smiling, sitting on a desk. And they actually think people are going to see them. You know?
Yeah. No. Well, listen, it's obvious you got a rich, full life, pal, so...
Boy.
All right.
I would get out a map of the U.S. today and start looking at it real serious.
Well,
I'm
moving to New York City.
No.
Yeah, in August.
Are you?
Yeah.
See, I had a thing about this guy. I just could tell in his voice that he's had it.
I'm so sick of South Florida, man. This town sucks.
You know, this town bites the big one. There's nothing going on here. It's as dead as a doornail. We got a bunch of old farts who are dried up in their condos running the whole town, driving everybody else out. It sucks. You know, if it wasn't for the weather, there wouldn't be three people here.
Hey, and the weather gets monotonous.
All these Chamber of Commerce people trying to blue sky everybody, telling everybody how wonderful it is, and the beach is as dead as a doornail, and the Fort Lauderdale is even deader. And
I hate the whole South Florida.
Boy, it just really sucks.
Fall off the map.
The biggest thing they got to talk about is whether the lottery drawing was kosher or not, whether we should do it over again, because if we do it over again, they're going to win it, right?
Yeah.
Bunch
of idiots. I won $5 on the scratch.
All right, now you're talking.
The biggest payoff I've ever had.
I got $76 ahead in the Canadian lottery, so look out, and I got 8 months of drawings to go.
All right, Neil. Well, I hope I brighten up your calling.
I got news for you. Your call was mediocre, but it was sensational compared to any yesterday.
I was full of information.
That's true.
You know, I didn't sound like an idiot, but I wasn't, you know, humorous.
Say goodbye.
Bye.
See ya. Now, he was very good, I must confess. Light years ahead of yesterday.
Well, not quite negative enough for me, but other than that...
He was honest, okay? He was honest. This town sucks. Let's stop covering up for all these Neanderthal politician and chamber types, okay? This town needs some goddamn life in it, okay? Somebody who's got enough balls to say, you know, this place is dying. Instead of all these articles, well, we built another strip shopping center this week, so everything's looking up. My God, in Plantation, we got enough strip shopping centers to last a lifetime. We could have the entire world shopping at our strip shopping centers. No restaurants, but a lot of strip shopping centers. It's 11:25 at WIOD, where everyone and everything is beautiful, okay? We have an open line in Dayton and one in Boca. Now that the lines are working, we got two stinking open lines.
Yeah.
What the hell is that all about? We're having a profound, meaty discussion of the current issues of the day, and we got two stinking open lines. And then Steve today is doing another abortion.
It's about time.
Yeah. I've been in abortion withdrawal myself. No, seriously, I keep poking all week long. I've been poking myself with a coat hanger because I just can't handle it. 11:25 at WIOD, Toya. Well, you're laughing, but if Steve had his way, that's what they'd be doing again, okay? That's what these poor women would be doing. They'd be running out there in back alleys with butchers and coat hangers.
Thank you.
Oh, it's a child in there. I want it. Lori and I will raise it.
Mm.
Anyway, Toyota of Hollywood with the best service department going anywhere. And as I said the other day, man, you can buy a car anywhere. Everybody and their brother is selling cars. But getting great service, that's another story. And the service department at Toyota of Hollywood's got all of the awards. They got, like, the President's Award. And they tried to give him the Vice President's Award, but they gave that one back. They want to be associated. But seriously, they really do a great job. In fact, they've got a little system there where you can actually stand and watch while they work on your car, which most places, they don't even want you to see what they're doing. And don't forget, the special in the service department for the month of April has been extended now this month throughout the rest of May. If you take your car in, mention WIOD, they will change the oil and filter for only $9.95 and also toss in a 25-point complete safety inspection. They will check your brakes, your tires, hoses, the whole schmear from top to bottom, all for just $9.95 when you mention WIOD. And while you're there, take a few minutes to browse around and check out the great selection of beautiful 89 Toyotas at lower-than-ever prices right now. It's a smart time to buy at Toyota of Hollywood on State Road 7. That's 441 between Taft and Sheridan Streets in Hollywood. Now, we heard the other day that Dion lives in North Bay Village.
That's
so
right.
Every once in a while, we're just going to play a little bit of Dion there. Not like the whole record, because that would be wrong. Magic would get upset. But, and then maybe he'll call in. Or stop by for lunch one day, Dion DiMucci. Wouldn't that be something? Came in, hung out for a while.
Yeah.
And people would be calling in and say, who's that? No, our audience is very Dion intensive, okay? Don't kid around with that. Okay, we have an open line in Dade County. I'm not giving these numbers out, okay, because we went through a traumatic hour. Most of the lines were screwed up, and we had all that hum and puke and pop on the phone. And if you don't want to talk to us, that's okay. We understand there's only 4 million people out there who could be listening to the show. I mean, this station reaches all the way up almost to Orlando.
That's right.
And we get into the big time. We get in Yeehaw Junction real good.
New Smyrna Beach.
Fort Drum.
That's right. Fort Drum, like a local.
Like a rock. Now, here's Jim from Specs. We don't want to keep Jim on the line too long because he may be paying for the call.
Hey,
how you doing, Jim?
No, I'm not paying for it.
Oh.
Speaking of Dion, he was here at the warehouse last week, believe
me. No, come on.
I'm serious. He said he really likes your show. And
no, come on. Dion doesn't listen to my show.
Hey, I got pictures to prove it.
Pictures of what? Wow.
You don't want to know. No, seriously, yeah. He came by here, and he said he really liked your show, and he... you know, would hopefully come on there sometime.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
So now, wait a minute. Let's slow down. The Mets, when they were in spring training, the Mets, when they played down here, the Orioles, for example, they were listening to this show in the dugout.
Yeah.
The Mets like the show. Dave Johnson and Tom Durkin are obsessed with the show. They're Neelys to the point of embarrassment.
Mm-hmm.
And now Dion, who lives in North Bay Village, turns out to be listening to this show.
I don't know if he's a Neely or not, but...
Well, I don't think you'd want to admit it.
Do you know anything about Monty Rock, if he listens?
Oh, I hope not. Oh, God, no. We got enough image problems already on our show.
You should listen to the new CD I sent.
Yeah, you really did. Well, you know, that new music, Pete Bolger once told me, he said, if you play new music, that's the kiss of death. But I have it right in my hand, King of the New York Streets.
Yeah, there's
the
a great song on there called Written on the Subway Wall.
Really?
It's got Paul Simon on it, too. It's a great track.
Really? I'm going to put it on this hour. I'm going to play it this hour.
Definitely
just because you're...
it.
And I sure appreciate all the good stuff you guys are
saying. Sure. We love your show, and, anything you need, just call us up.
If you have an oldie CD with Pretty Little Angel Eyes by Curtis Lee, I would sure love to have that, because I had that, but, of course, I left a lot of my oldie stuff at Zeta, and now they're never going to give it back, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Pretty Little Angel Eyes.
That's the one. Don't embarrass yourself on here now, Jim. Come on. You were doing so well, and now all of a sudden you're lapsing into this.
I'll check that out for you.
Thank you, sir. You're a gentleman, a scholar. Say hi to Dion. I'm a big fan, by the way.
Okay.
Tell him to bring over a sack of money.
Okay.
Thanks, Jim.
See ya.
Bye. That is shocking, okay? You'd be pretty damn amazed at who's listening to this show every day, you know what? You would be shocked.
Yeah.
Shocked. Dion. Wow. Paul Simon, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, 11:55. What?
It'll probably make you real jealous, but Joe Johnson has a Kelly & Klein coffee cup in his
house. Oh, boy. Can I have one too, Joe? Wow.
Anyway, you got a real nice birthday gift there from Mary in Fort Lauderdale, and it's a huge balloon, and all the stuff is inside, so you got to pop
the
balloon.
Got to pop the balloon. They don't usually let me have these razor blades, you know.
No, they hide them for me. Far away. Oh, jeez. Even when you know it's
wow.
Happen, it's shocking.
And let's see what's in here. Oh. Candy.
Yeah, there's some nice candy.
Mm-hmm.
English toffee. I love that stuff.
Yeah.
It's fattening as hell, but I still love it.
Tons of it.
And?
That's all just candy.
Oh, that's it. But
yeah,
it's cute.
It's real cute. Different.
And it's in the form like a big egg inside the balloon, like a gigantic egg. It's got a little nest in
Mary,
there.
Mary, a loyal fan.
Yeah, it's got a little nest.
Yeah, it's a
under
nest.
The candy.
Exactly.
That's really cute. Thank you, Mary. You're just a... Dion has moved to Boca from North Bay Village. Well, what the hell's going on, Dion?
Geez,
you're finally getting smart in your old age, huh?
Oh, my.
Well, half smart. He got out of North Bay Village, but now he's into Boca. Well, North Bay Village is like kind of marginal.
Well, the problem with North Bay Village is you have to drive down 79th Street to get there.
Yeah,
and,
unless you got a helicopter. Unless you know Clarence. He moved to Boca. No wonder Dion is... little psychotic these days, huh? Okay, we got a couple of open lines on the board, and we had a first hour that was desperate. The lines were all messed up, and since then we've had shocking calls. Shocking!
Yes. Very true.
Including Jim from Specs and John Hambone, and God only knows who'll be calling in the next 2 hours. Of course, we're not too excited about it, because any minute Peppers is going to be coming with lunch, which has become kind of like a thing on the show now.
So Johnny
lunch
can't get through.
At the Moldies.
Because all the Broward
well, Johnny can call
up.
Collect on the Boca line or the Palm Beach line.
True.
Or he can pay for it, okay?
No, Boca's open, right?
What, he can call Boca?
I know, on the Boca line.
And Palm Beach.
Okay, they're open.
Yeah, come on, Johnny, stop being a douchebag. Well,
Phillip
he's probably real busy looking for a job.
What? Yeah, right. Oh, this is filler to news? Is that what this
and
is?
And now, here's Gray Slick for Flintstone Vitamins.
Like bread. Hi, boys and girls. I'm Gracie Slick. You know, when I was on the road with Jefferson Airplane in the 60s, I chased a lot of white rabbits, and I usually chased them with scotch. Hey, but I don't get high anymore. Now I like to get Flintstoned. I just drop a couple of Betty's or Dino's before a concert, and soon I'm getting a buzz on vitamins and minerals, just like that modern Stone Age family down the street. Now, when the white knight is talking backwards, I know my turntable's probably just in reverse. So when the men on the chessboard get up and tell you where to go, tell them you're going for some Flintstone vitamins. And remember... Eat your bread. Eat your bread.
Yeah.
I thought it was the record.
Isn't it great?
That's
some good
it was
stuff
the
on
record.
There this week. Too bad we don't have the cue sheets. Anyway, Steve has got another abortion today from 2 to 6. We'll tell you a lot more about that later, much later, including the Reverend Pat Mahoney is going to be on for the 82nd time this week, which is shocking. Sports Talk, Sonny and Joe with Lou Gorman, GM of the Boston Red Sox. And, boy, thank God we don't have anybody from the Yankees on. And then we got Bush Bing Bang just briefly. About an hour and a half is all we can take. And the Yankee game at Oakland is at 9:35. So that's pretty much the agenda. That's the lay of the land, as they say. And Scott Sanderson is pitching for the Cubs today, so some of us are going to be rushing out, having dinner at Mom's tonight.
Ah.
Well, you know how we have to kind of arrange these things
priorities.
Around the Cubs games. Anyway, April Wortham is here with a noon WIOD News. That ought to get a lot of guys perked up right on the edge of their seats. And then we'll be back with more and probably with lunch.
Mm-hmm.
Huh? At about 12:05. We sure wish you could be here to enjoy that delicious, mouth-watering Mexican food from Peppers, but better us than you, I guess, huh?
Our careers have been battered around. Even groupies are turning us down. It's so hard to keep a hip sound. Get me my wheelchair. Wish my face was rearrangeable. It's kind of wrinkly and unstraightenable. Father Time's so deplorable. Get me my wheelchair. I'm so old and looking homely. An elderly Pillsbury doughboy. Pretty soon I'll be losing my hair.
My aching body needs a cane to lean. Denture cream.
Used to look sharp when we were lads, but Keith Richards out, that's truly sad. Get me my wheelchair. Voices shot, but I'll still sell a million. Cause it sounds good next to Bob Dylan.
Give me my name.
Now that we have made a killing, get me my wheelchair.
Give me my Girathon.
Where's my Gale Vector?
I need tools and a legs in it. How are you?
Where's my glasses?
Who's gonna go? Ouch! I haven't done any of the weed.
That is hard to believe. Anyway, it's 12:08 at WIOD, and our friends are here with the food.
Yes, Peppers.
Is that shocking? From Peppers, which is right up the street behind the place for steak, if we can mention that. And look at that. We got chicken burritos and beef fajitas and rice and beans. Ooh, no beans for me. My dogs get real upset. And beef burritos and quesadillas and all kinds of sauce. Oh, my gosh. Shrimp and jalapeno fajitas. That sounds like orgasmic. Chicken fajitas. And lots of food here today, so we'll kind of like sort it out first and see what's left over for the peons. Wow.
Good.
You guys went crazy here. Thank you very much. Well, listen, the feeling is mutual when you're feeding us like this. Is there soup?
Tortilla soup.
Tortilla soup. Ooh, that sounds right up my alley. Tortilla soup. Man, I think I once had tortilla soup. It was excellent. So we're ready for a little lunch now. So you guys out there in the audience, eat your hearts out. We're eating great food, and you're eating your hearts out. Are there some spoons over there, too, by any chance? What? Inside? No, these look like forks to me, unless they're making spoons in a new shape now. These look like forks. Anyway, it's not... Ooh, what the hell is that? Oh, my God. Let me just take a peek at that. Mm-mm. Wow. Just tell Sandy about this, okay? Was she trying to scoff it up before you brought it back here, no doubt? Now, she's all right. She's just going through change of life. This is just... I can't even believe this. See, what I'm going to do... I mean, it's kind of ridiculous, but what I do is I eat this stuff without the tortilla. I just eat this. I understand that, but I don't want to gain all that weight back that I lost. This is where all the... This is fattening. This is not, right? That sounds good. It sounds good, okay? Trust me. Just agree with me. Boy, this is tremendous. Gentlemen, you have really outdone yourself. This is kind of a little early birthday celebration for you, right?
Kinda,
first the
yeah.
balloon, and now we got enough food from Peppers to kill the army. Wow, this is incredible. And, in fact, we got probably some spoons back here or somewhere. We had a million spoons yesterday for the soup. 10 past noon at WIOD. It's lunchtime at the Moldies. No, don't worry. We got spoons. We got forks. We got it all here, man. When you got as much food coming in as we do every day, you got enough utensils to... a little sour cream. Ooh, not for me. Ooh. Not quite. That's the only thing I don't like is guacamole. But I'm sure you love it, don't you?
Sure.
Okay, just pour it on his head. And here's Nick, probably got some spoons. Look at this. We got utensils that haven't been made yet for dishes that haven't been cooked. Yeah, there we go. Look at that little soup spoon. We got that tortilla soup, just a little cup, perhaps. I don't want to be pushy or anything. Look at this. We got a call from Halton City, Texas. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Okay. How you doing there, buddy?
All right. I called you from Jupiter a couple weeks ago and told you I was moving out here.
From Jupiter.
Yeah.
Now in Texas and probably after that on Uranus, right?
Could be.
Well, that tortilla
soup. We're out here, we're having like flash
excellent.
Flood watches today and all this kind of stuff. How are things down there?
Hey, things down here are as boring as ever, pal. It's just terminal, okay? But we got an exciting lunch from Peppers. We got some Mexican food going to spice up our life a little, if you know
all
what
right.
I mean.
Hey, the talk radio really needs to be lightened up around here.
I'm sure they got some real great liberal voices out there in Texas. How like at Halton City?
Oh, boy, aside from the religious radio.
I heard it's so good out there you have to put a sheet over your radio before you turn it on. Is that true?
That's true.
Yeah.
It's state law.
Mm-hmm.
No doubt about it. Well, I just wanted to say hey and...
Okay, listen, say hi to John Tower for us, too, okay?
Okay.
And tell him to have one on us.
Yeah.
Okay, thanks a lot, pal.
Put a pin in the map for me.
Okay, you got it.
Bye now.
Bye. This is great, gentlemen. This is phenomenal. Are you all ready? Look at that. He didn't waste any time. Mm-hmm. He just digs right in.
Right into it.
And goes nuts. What are you eating now? Shrimp. And shrimp and what?
Jalapeno, yeah.
It's fajitas.
Little hot, I like it.
A little on the hot side. That's why the steam is coming out of your ears.
That's right.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Like
this is tremendous, and we can't thank you enough, believe me. Okay, good to see you. Keep it up. so to speak. Okay, it's 12 past noon at WIOD. Speaking of food, before I sink my teeth into all of this fantastic stuff, we want to tell you about another one of our favorites. 12:37 at WIOD. Boy, they sure made quick order a lot of this stuff, didn't they? They just went nuts. Right?
Good.
Well, yeah. That is good. Yeah, we don't want to have a lot of stuff left over because Steve is another one of those abortion shows. We don't want his guests to lose their appetite, you know what I'm saying? Okay, we have an open line in Dade County, 751-WIOD. Let's go to Miami. Hello.
Hi there.
Yeah.
Great show.
Really?
Every routine that you have is terrific.
Every routine?
Every routine. Playing the records, playing the tapes, playing the cards.
Yeah.
Hello?
And?
I'm out of material.
Okay, well, now I know why you're so easy to please. Good luck to you, pal. Wow, the guy's laughing too much. That lady will call back, sir. I had to cut you short. The lady will go nuts. Now, excuse me while I extend my long cord.
Where are you going?
Well, I just want to see if there's anything left.
Oh.
Because what I had was delicious, but it did not constitute everything, no? Well, like, here's a, what? Look at this. These schleppers are back for more now. They're out of their minds. Ooh, rice and beans. No, I don't think I'm going to participate in that. What's in the, is there anything in there? Oh, yeah, I'm going to stop that because there's nothing fattening there. That's great. It must have been tremendous because the newsroom is back for seconds now.
Incredible.
They're going nuts.
Incredible.
Oh, look at that. Ah, oh, I just munged all over myself and all over the floor and all over everywhere. It's okay. I got it. Just a little bit. Just a little thing. Not too bad. Okay, it's 12:39 at WIOD at All Food Radio. I think we could start a new format from this, don't you? Just eating all day long. We have different places coming in, like for breakfast and lunch and dinner and snack places, you know? And then we get our ice cream places in the evening. Not a bad idea. And then during Bush Bing Bang, we could, like, bring in arsenic and stuff like that. Okay, 21 till 1. Let's get serious. Let's start doing a radio show here, okay, when I'm through eating, which is going to be a while. Yeah, I munged on my beautiful trouser leg there. But I saved it from hitting the floor. I wouldn't want to get Steve apoplectic, you know, because he's got a heavy, heavy abortion show on today, which is very unusual on a Kane show. By the way, the guy called me back. You know, the fellas that brought the food from Peppers, and he forgot to call Dwight and Tim, the owner's douchebag. Do that for them. And we just did it. Now, is there some more? Is there another fork anywhere? I'm sure there are. Here's one right here. Boy, this must be my lucky day. I should go out to the track and plunge my brains up, but I'm not going to. Because I got to see that Cubs game, boy. It's going to be heavy duty today. With Scott Sanderson pitching, we'll need all the help we can get. Anyway, so this is the chicken fajita without the tortilla. Oh, with the onions and peppers and tomatoes. Is this bad radio? We do have an open line in Dade County still. I don't know why. We've taken at least four calls today, haven't we? Including one from John Hamburg.
Excuse me.
It was interesting hearing from John, wasn't it?
You know, they have...
not real interesting, but it was marginally interesting.
Sonsky has a column in the Herald this morning. Steve Sonsky about NBC's new fall shows that will be on John Hamburg stations. The best...
It's John Hamburg station?
John Hamburg station, yeah. You didn't know? But the most interesting one is called... You'll be able to relate to this. It's called Nut House. It'll be a new fall show. It'll be on Wednesday night. Mel Brooks put this together with...
I love Mel Brooks.
Yeah, with Alan Spencer, who did Sledgehammer, which a lot of... Cloris Leachman will be in it. Harvey Korman will be in it.
Well, here's somebody in a Grove who can't afford to wait. Hello.
Hi, Neil.
What does that mean, you can't afford to wait?
I run my lunch break, and you know how it is.
Oh, okay.
Oh,
how are you guys doing today?
Well, I was kind of in the middle of something, but go ahead.
Oh,
I'm sure you're much more important.
I saw a sense of urgency on the screen with this call.
Yeah, well, I had to speak to you. I've never called before. And I just thought it was time.
Time for what?
Then I call you once in a while. Give me a call every for a month or
two. What? What?
Just give you a call once in a while.
Forget it. Okay, go ahead. Well, that was ridiculous. I don't even know what that was.
What was
you
that?
You know, I don't know. Well, it was from the Grove. Doesn't that answer the question?
Yeah. First we have that, and then I see Bill Wise in front of me. And
oh,
what a day this is. Would you like some food,
He's upset because we played all that great music this morning, and their numbers are trembling.
Here he comes.
Yeah.
Would you like some food?
We put them to sleep over a GTR, man.
Bill? Would you like
I mean, when we played Judas Priest, he was nervous, but when we followed it with Led Zeppelin, he was just foaming at the mouth. He was. Go ahead.
But anyway, I was reading over some of these other shows. One's called...
What is this about FM being dead in this market? What are you talking about?
What is that crap? Oh, we don't want to play dirty stuff in here. Go take that next door. Mama's got a squeeze box. Squeeze this, will you? Get out of here.
GTR? Is that GTR?
Well, listen to that good signal, too.
I'm in the building.
Can barely pick it up. Well, we're pretty far from the antenna, you know, from the stick.
That's true.
Get it out of here. We don't play filthy stuff like that on AM. No.
Would you like some, Bill? There he goes.
What
maniac.
What a madman, huh?
Out of
Mama's
his
got
mind.
A... Squeeze this, okay? Boy. What a potty mouth. Wash your CD player out with Clorox. Go ahead.
That was a lot better than what I was doing.
Well, I forgot what you're doing already. Oh, about NBC's new show.
I was talking about the new show.
Mel Brooks?
Yeah, that's the Nut House, which I thought you'd like to
name
it.
Oh, see?
Yeah.
It's fitting in right now.
But some of these others, one's called Baywatch with Parker Stevenson.
Baywatch?
Another one is called Hardball. It'll be on Friday nights. But I was reading the little description of all these, and it reminded me of Network. It sounded just like Network. Now, here's one called Mancuso FBI. It will be on Friday night with Robert Logia.
Oh, yeah, that's taped in Batavia, New York, Mancuso.
Yeah. He reprises his role as Nick Mancuso, a crusty, dedicated FBI agent.
A crusty but benign
yeah,
lawyer.
Who hates bureaucracy but can't resist intriguing, baffling crimes. Now, doesn't that sound exactly like the description of the shows when they did it in Network? That was all. That's
All we need is Faye Dunaway to come in here and read that.
But Nut House looks real promising. Mel Brooks doing a TV show. It'll be on Wednesday nights at 9:30. That's exciting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Whatever you say.
Well, John Hambrick, I'm sure, is... very excited today.
So anyway, it's 12:44. Just to get even with Spike Wise.
What goes on in the apartment next to mine? It gets loud in the middle of the night. Well, they crank that music as high as it will go, and it sounds like Metallica. Well, they have long hair and lots of tattoos. Seeing them in daylight gives me a fright. The music is so fast and it's so loud. Oh, they say they love Metallica. Do you suppose that they could turn it down so I could get some sleep for once? The walls they shake, the pictures fall.
I don't like that. Anyway, here's an interactive, but... It's a demo.
This interactive demo is an example of how this might sound on your station.
We hope not.
Let's call Cubs broadcaster and future Hall of Famer Harry Carey. Got his number right here. Punch this in. Harry Carey, Cubs broadcaster. And the phone is ringing. Waiting for Harry. Oh, hello, Harry?
Hello again, everybody. This is Harry Carey. Oh. The Cubs and I will be home on the 16th and 17th. We'll be back on the road and home on the 20th. In the meantime, when you hear the tone... Well, that's not the tone, is it? No. Anyway, when you hear the tone, just leave a message and I'll get back to you. And remember, any rebroadcast, reproduction, or other use of the description of this recorded message is strictly prohibited. So... There it is! It might be! It could be! It is the code! Holy cow! So everybody!
Harry, I know they're putting you in the Hall of Fame this year, but if you don't start taking your medications, they'll be putting you in another kind of institution. Bye-bye. Call you later. Thanks.
Yeah. Boy, that demo. Don't you like the way they do those? Those interactives? Those are heavy duty.
My favorite interactives.
This is me to assume that somebody would give me a diet soda again. Wouldn't it?
Probably.
Because it happened like 2 days in last week.
Yeah.
Because I'm almost out. I'm almost down to my little tiny thing.
You don't want
to
push it.
Well, you know, since we feed the whole building, I assume that maybe just once in a great while I could impose upon them to... Well, we'll see. We'll see what happens. If somebody comes rushing up here with a Diet Coke, or not, as the case may be, we won't feel bad. We just won't give you any more food. Miami, hello.
Hey, Neil, how you doing?
Great.
Glenn, happy birthday.
Thank you, sir.
What a lunch today.
Yeah, it sounds like you had a good time.
Shocking.
I want to check that place out one day.
It's great.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Listen, first of all, I want to defend Glenn with that lady that called and didn't like the laughing and the cackling.
Uh-huh.
Oh, I happen to like it, you know. A lot of times people don't understand, you know, they don't see what's going on there in the studio that, you know, that you find funny, you know what I mean?
Well, it's an interesting thing to complain about. I always find that fascinating.
They don't have depressing lives. They don't want to
obviously,
hear
them
laughing.
Obviously, yeah, obviously. Can you imagine complaining about laughing? Just amazes me.
Sad lies.
I guess. I guess it's pathetic. I guess we should be glad we're not like that, I guess. I don't know. I don't know what to think about it.
Nothing wrong with laughing.
Yeah.
So anyway, hey, listen, I like those new power rejoins, those real short ones.
That's my doing now, sir. That's part of my floor mat.
They're really great. I like them.
Well, that's no good.
Right away, you know. Just
okay, well, I'm glad we got your stamp of approval.
Yeah, good. I saw Peter Bulger, and he said he'd like to get in on the GTR pool, you know, when's the colonel leaving?
I got news for you. You may see Peter Bulger at the bottom of the GTR pool pretty soon.
I don't doubt it. One more thing before I go. Does Rob blow?
Have a nice day, sir. 1254 at WIOD. We have an open line in Dade, 751-9463. 751-WIOD. here comes the definitive story on the album from Mr. Music in there from Nick. Dion Subway Walls is good, but the rest of the album is filler, he said. Every record on here is a classic. This is a great record right here. Sensation. Well, all these great background vocals and everything. I bet you And the Night Stood Still is great, too.
Do you think they'll play any of this on...
They won't play it anywhere in this market, okay? Because this market sucks when it comes to music, okay?
Yeah, but what
they
about
play
on,
nothing.
What about on WRMF?
Oh. Only if they can talk over the last half hour. They do talk ups and talk outs. By the time they get done, there's like about 25 seconds of music left on WRMF. Close.
Just like that. That's how they do it.
They step on it.
They don't care.
This is a great album.
The moment I lived in your eyes, I never will forget.
Now, this is called a talk through, right?
Yeah, talk through. Okay, well, I'm going to listen to it in the car on the way home. Now, I usually listen to Steve, but, of course, he's doing abortion today, so now I've got something to listen to.
Right.
Great album. It's Dion, and it's called Yo Frankie. Yo.
Yo.
On Arista Records. And little did I know, when we started today, we'd be playing Yo. Little did I know. Thanks to Jim at Specs. And, of course, the perspicacious John Hambrick, whose taste in music is almost as good as his taste in women. 22, whatever that means. I thought it sounded good. 22 after 1 at WIOD. And Toyota of Hollywood, boy, have they got a deal for you. Those incredible factory rebates. You add on top of that all the great savings that they normally pass along. And then you add on top of that the extra savings that a lot of car dealers are passing along now. And you've got what it boils down to, a fantastic deal. $2,500 factory rebates on all MR2s, $1,000 to $2,000 rebates on those beautiful Toyota Camrys, and $1,400 rebates on Toyota pickup trucks. So for the deal of a lifetime, get in right now to Toyota of Hollywood. And don't forget, the service department throughout the rest of this month continues the WIOD special. Mention WIOD. They'll give you an oil change plus filter and a 25-point safety check from top to bottom. All of that only $9.95 at the Southeast's numero uno Toyota dealer, Toyota of Hollywood. On 441 at State Road 7 between Taft and Sheridan Streets in Hollywood.
This is the Neil Rogers Show. This is your brain. Any questions?
He's an agent provocateur.
1:05 past 1 at WIOD. We had to get that somewhere along the line. We had to get
that. That was great, yeah.
Captain Dave and Dick Motherly together in stereo. Palm Beach, hello.
Hi, how you doing, Neil?
Okay.
We're great fans of yours.
Well, that's great.
My name's Vic from Wide World of Sporting Goods, and we were talking, we just had an incident. A friend of mine next door to Aileen, Seema Moskowitz, she went down there, and she was telling me how nasty they are. You remember, like, you were talking a couple months ago?
Seema Moskowitz?
Yeah.
Huh?
She went down where?
To the bagel place, Miriam's Bagel Place, where you used to eat.
What? What are you talking about?
Remember you said how nasty those old ladies are down at that bagel place?
I never ate at any bagel place. I never eaten at a bagel place in my life.
Oh, you're kidding.
No.
You're always talking about it.
I think are you having hallucinations?
Yeah, maybe.
I think you probably had too many prune homintosh at one time, and it's kind of carrying over.
Anyway.
Is that possible?
That's possible. Anything's possible.
Yeah.
I just wanted to know, do you ever eat at DeSalvo's Pizza?
All the time. It's okay. Great.
I just spoke with Steve, and he told me to tell you, because we're trying to get you in here, to come here and make an appearance at the Wide World of Sporting Goods, and he said to invite you to his new grand opening in Plantation.
Yeah, that's right up the street from me. That's by my old Winn-Dixie.
Right, so, and, you know...
Well, when is that going to be?
They just opened, but he said, you know, they were really packed and everything, but he told me to tell you, or asked me to tell you, to invite you to come here anytime.
Oh, that's great. I'll be there. I love DeSalvo's. Their food is great, and they're super folks.
Yeah. And are you into any sports at all?
Am I into any sports?
Have you ever heard this show, sir?
Well, meaning sports yourself.
He means as a
participant. Oh, I'm sorry.
Physically.
Yeah, okay.
The Cubs and everything else.
Got it. Right. Okay.
I'm into mind wrestling.
mind wrestling. Well, I'll tell you, anytime you need anything, you can feel free to come in here and have a free-for-all.
Okay. Sounds
right.
Good to me.
We're right across from the Broward Mall, so Wide World of Sports. Sporting Goods, okay?
Right across from the Broward Mall, like on which...
On the east side of University.
I got it. Right over there by the that one restaurant there where they have armpits for the... I understand what you're talking about.
Right.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Okay, thank
See
you.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa.
That was pretty shocking. One at 127 at WIOD. We have an open line in Palm Beach, 655 WIOD. I'm trying to just relax now because all of that hot, spicy, the Mexican food is great. And then, of course, the tortilla soup kind of like is churning it all up there.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just trying to sit here and just let it all kind of percolate, you know, and just kind of mellow out. You know what I'm saying?
Kind of.
And hope that it just stops gurgling a little bit. Boy, it was great. It was really tremendous. And Thursday, Hank's going to be here. It's the bird's birthday, so we hope that people out there who like bake cakes and stuff like that. Well, I don't know what you're laughing about.
God,
it's a good way to get
old.
We have a giant party here on Thursday, okay?
Yeah, I'm sure it will
be. A big celebration. Maybe even Boom Boom will show up. Let's hope not.
God knows who.
Miami, hello.
Hey, Neil.
And we can invite Johnny Dark to come in?
Uh-huh.
He's looking for a free meal.
Let me ask you a question, Neil. If the bird went to work at the Motivation Station, would they change the name to W. Glenn NN?
That's cute.
One more thing, I
wonder whatever happened to old Glenn with two N's there. You remember our friend Joe?
Yeah, I sure do.
I wonder whatever happened to Joe, you know? I guess he's working for the CIA now, okay? Couldn't find anything in my house, so now he's working for the CIA.
Oh, well.
What a deal that was. Someday I'm going to tell that whole story on the air. It was incredible.
Hmm.
It was shocking.
We're waiting to hear it.
You know what they say about Joe, don't you?
He's an agent provocateur.
Yeah. With two ends.
Put me a hole for the lightning round?
Sure, no problem. What line are you on?
Line two.
I love these punk kids that call in. Every time you got a wrestler on, hey, Dust, how you doing, man? All of a sudden they get like real butch, you know, real macho and real like, Dusty. And Dusty, of course, is putting his wig back in place. It's great. 21 till 2 at WIOD. I heard that story Dusty was telling about that voluptuous blonde and, you know, and all that. He didn't say it was a guy, though. Anyway, let's take a few more calls here because we're getting really close to that exciting point of the show where we say goodbye. That's the exciting point to me. Not the lightning round, but when we say goodbye,
I thought you were going to...
this tremendous feeling of release.
I thought you were going to... I thought you were going to tell some Dusty Rhodes stories.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Okay. I don't know anything about Dusty Rhodes, and I'm sure he's a wonderful, swell fellow, but I don't know anything about those professional wrestlers, okay? There's still a lot of grappling and groping going on, and all these young guys, oh, man, they're so macho. You know, it's so anyway, there were these two priests sitting at this bar. Okay, Steve, today, reaction to that exciting Roe versus Wade NBC TV movie that was on last night. Susan Glickman, pro-choice liberal. Melissa Dunn, pro-choice conservative. Reverend Pat Mahoney of the Florida Rescue making another guest appearance for the 400th time this month. And attorney Barry Silver joins the fray at 4 p.m. for a veritable verbal brawl and fistfight on the Steve Kane Show.
He joins the fray.
Okay. And then on Sports Talk, Joe Zagacki and Sonny Hirsch together in stereo with Lou Gorman, general manager of the Red Sox, who will explain to us why all his players are so ugly. And then a little bit of Bush Bing Bang, followed by Yankee baseball against the A's in Oakland at 9:35. So we got some kind of lineup on WIOD tonight. We can't say what kind, but we got some kind of lineup. Pembroke Pines, hello.
Holding for the lightning round.
Okay.
Ah, how many is that?
Fort Lauderdale, hello.
Hello, I'm holding it for the lightning round.
Okay, don't hold too tight now. Let's see, where are we going?
Three.
West Palm Beach?
Uh-oh.
West Palm Beach isn't even smart enough to hold for the lightning round. They don't know what they're holding up there. Miami, hello.
Neil, I think you'll like this. Listen carefully.
I'm listening.
You're a mother pheasant plucker. You pluck mother pheasants.
Yeah. 141. That's as far as I'm going with that. Okay, it was fine at that point, but that's as, it's almost the end of the show, and I'm not taking my life in my hands. Boca, hello.
Hey, Neil.
Yeah.
The Dion sounds like a hit.
Yeah.
It sounds really good.
It's a great album, boy.
I predict Y100 will be playing Gotta Get to You by August 1st.
Y100?
Yep.
By August 1st. Where
does that come from?
Of which year? They may be playing Hungarian Rhapsodies by August 1st if they keep dropping.
I've got a WOLD spy report.
They got a new format over there. It's called Drop Like a Rock.
I got an OLD spy report for you.
Okay.
They're broadcasting over life phone.
Oh, that's cute. That is really cute.
Uh-huh. Is Bill Wise in the room?
No, thank God he's not. He can't handle when he hears all this new good music, man. He just runs for the hills, you know?
I got some great music for him I want him to add.
Yeah.
But thanks.
Okay.
See ya.
Bye.
Fascinating.
What did that mean?
Fascinating call.
I just lost him there in that last little thought. 142 at WIOD. Too bad somebody doesn't come in here and clean out this garbage, you know? We don't want to ask for much. But we do have several large waste baskets, and it would be nice if the people that come in and eat all the stuff, if they would just assist us in getting rid of the garbage, and it's not a big deal. In fact, maybe they would, like, bring one of those waste baskets, mm-hmm. schlep it in here, one that's not filled, and just toss these few remaining things in there, because my waste basket's full to the brim. And I feel kind of guilty every day anyway, because the time Steve comes in here, that thing is, it's overflowing. Because when I start, it's two-thirds full. Don't you think maybe we could afford a little bigger wastebasket than this little crappy thing we got under here? Like one in the corner behind that potted plant or something that, you know, big enough to throw all the schmutz out in so we don't have to keep getting Dorothy apoplectic in the newsroom. I don't see anybody rushing in to get garbage.
No. Let's see if this is a false
okay,
alarm.
I mean, if you're gonna, wait a minute.
Oh.
Look at that.
Would
that would
you?
Be so, just this stuff
please.
Here would be so nice. Thank you
Thank
very
you.
Much.
Thank
now, don't let Dorothy get hysterical if you put it in the newsroom
Make
waste basket.
Make two trips.
Dorothy goes nuts. Yeah, she gets really hysterical. 143 at WIOD, Fort Lauderdale. Hello.
Hey, Neil. How you doing?
Great.
Yeah, I think I know the song you're looking for, but what, Dion there?
Yeah.
It's called Teenager in Love. That's the song that you've, that's got the twinkle, twinkle.
What's the one that I just played?
No, it's not. It goes twinkle, twinkle, little star.
How I wonder.
Each night
is that it?
Yeah, that's it.
All right, let me, I can get it out here. Just Teenage in Love with Sunday. This will kill some good time.
Out, okay?
Wait a minute. But just a second.
He wants to hold on for the
I'll
lightning.
I'll let you hold, but just relax a second. Don't get hyper on me, okay?
Okay.
I mean, life is more than just the lightning round. Of course, when you live in this town, it's not much more than a lightning round, but I can't help that. I'm doing my best. Which one did... Oh, I played Lonely Teenager. It's Teenager in Love.
Oh, well, those... You get it straight. Come on.
Get it straight. Not on this show. Hold on. Okay, you're a great American, sir. Thank you so much. I think he's right. This doesn't have a little twinkle, twinkle.
No, but this was a big hit.
That's the name of the song, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star.
Oh.
This, on the other hand, is Teenager in Love.
Each time we have a quarrel, it almost
right?
breaks my heart.
Right? This has got nothing to do with...
But it's great to hear again.
Twinkle. No, well, it is, yeah, but we don't have... Oh, yeah.
No, why love you like I don't? No, why?
This is one of Nick's favorites.
See, you don't understand. Nick knows nothing about Philly music, okay? This is Ernie Maresca and Dion and all these Italian kids from Philly. Weren't we talking, excuse me, about that before? He was asking us about that.
Yeah, they're from all
it's
from
Sha-na-na.
Philly.
No, it's not Sha-na-na. Yeah, they ripped it off from Sha-na-na. Oh,
these kids today.
Pathetic, isn't it?
Well, you know, they're the
Shocking.
Only kids we have.
It's embarrassing.
Tell me why the stars in the sky are the same.
Belmont, without these. Belmont's without Dion had a couple of really big hits. Come On, Little Angel. I got those at home somewhere. Oh, I love Come On, Little Angel.
Amazing.
Has anybody over at Specs got the Belmonts?
And
not the Dion, but the Belmont. Like Come On, Little Angel, and what was the other one? I Need Someone. Those were the two big ones. I Need Someone and Come On, Little Angel. They were great. Come On, Little Angel was tremendous. It was orgasmic. It was so good. It was just a great record.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, it's 1:45. I have no idea what that accomplished, but like I told you, killed a couple of really valuable minutes.
That
thank
sounded
God
good.
For small
sounded
favors.
Really
thank
good.
You, sir. I know you're holding, and thank you so much. Now, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star is the name of the record. Not Little Star. That's by the Elegants. And also, yeah. Of course, the Diamonds destroyed it. They ruined it. But... Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. And he says whatever the line is that Paul Simon sings in this mm-hmm. other song, which I'm going to go nuts. I'm going to listen to this whole album on the way home, which has got to be... you know something?
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy. Well, you see what happened. I got to get gas.
You got
on
the wrong
home.
Car. Don't you?
No.
Is that what you're saying?
No.
No?
I got CD players
oh,
in
good.
All of my cars. I'm not some kind of schmerl, some kind of schmemeric.
Well, then what's the problem?
I got to get gas.
Oh.
And I don't... I was too lazy to get gas this morning coming to work. And you know how in my Corvette I got one of those digital things where it shows you how many miles you have left?
How many?
I got, it varies depending on the mileage that you're getting. So yeah. Once I get on a turnpike or on 95, if it's clear sailing, and you're getting about 24, 25 miles to a gallon, it goes up.
Yeah.
I got, I think, 37
uh-huh.
miles left.
Uh-huh.
And I think it's about like 40 miles from here to my house.
Mm-hmm.
Should I chance it? Because, you know, when the Cubs are playing, I get like a bat out of hell. In fact, yesterday I got home just after... McClendon hit the three-run homer, and Dave said it's 3-0. And I thought, and the Cubs only scored one more run the whole rest of the game.
Now, is that the same guy that started all the radio
Gordon
stations?
Gordon McClendon, yeah. W4, and then in Dallas he had a big
He's
station.
Playing for the Cubs
He's
now.
He's playing for the Cubs. Well, anybody Great. Can hit for the Cubs now. Anybody can do better than Mitch Webster.
Well, that Gordon.
And then Gerald Perry for the Braves had 0-35 a streak, and then the best way to break a bad streak is to play against the Cubs. He batted twice, he pinched it, he batted, got a walk and a single. So when you're in a bad streak, just play against the Cubs and you'll break out of it, okay? 147 at WIOD, we're going to get in the lightning round, which I guess we must, but if you guys need a little help knowing what the lady in your life, I think we ought to do the other one, don't you?
Oh.
If flowers in a bottle of wine make your lover smile, imagine what a gift from Pat... Just out of spite, because I knew where the pin would go on a thing.
Uh-huh.
And we were on I-94 in Michigan, headed for the track, and I pulled off the exit. In fact, it sputtered on the highway and stalled out. And I started it again, and it started up.
Did it really?
And he was screaming, and I pulled off the exit. There was a Shell station, and I pulled in, and I coasted to the pump,
uh-huh.
and it stopped right at the pump. And this guy was just hysterical, my former sales manager in Kalamazoo. Anyway, let's get with us now. 152, Dade County, hello.
Yeah.
What is that?
Oh, I don't know.
Well, whatever it was, you're SOL, pal. Dade, hello.
That's about as exciting as Tom Denenberg.
That was good. Boca, hello.
Steve KSM sales says I'm that Russian man, the douchebag.
We got a computer doing douchebag stories. That's
I
great.
Like that.
Palm Beach, hello.
Hello, doctor. Take my temperature.
Broward, hello.
Bird, I'm crying over here.
Dade County, hello.
Los Cops, mama.
Oh, jeez. That was just all right, I guess. There's some truth to that. Broward, hello.
Don't be a date,
153 at WIOD. No more foreign language comments, okay? All in English today, all right? I know what that one means. All in English, please. Boy, these guys.
We have to wait for the delay.
Yeah, we got the new ethnic lightning
round. You know, I was downstairs. I think they hear the show in the building pre-delay.
Do
Did
they?
You know that?
Well, that's good. They probably get to
they
hear
do.
A lot of good. Well, that's great. You hear the good stuff that
they
ever
get
gets
to
on
hear
air.
The good stuff.
Broward, hello.
Is it true that WLS is really Larry Kent in drag?
Yes.
Yeah.
Boca, hello.
Mike Disney is a douchebag.
Tell us something we don't know, sir. Broward, hello.
Come on, Glenn, give us a chuckle.
Let's see. WYNF in Tampa just added two cuts from the Dion album.
Really?
King of New York Streets, which we haven't even heard yet. We just heard a little bit of that.
Wait
and
little.
The Subway Walls. Written
That's
on the Subway Walls.
AOR station.
Yeah.
Wait a while. WYNF.
Yeah, how about that, Spike? Get with it. Start playing some goddamn music on that station over here next door, will
you? You blew it on Orbison.
Exactly. You blew the Roy Orbison cut. It was only number one AOR in the country.
Mm-hmm.
And
Wouldn't
maybe
play.
Now hop on Dion, so to speak. Dade County, hello.
Hello, good evening.
Yeah. Oh, God. It's the young lightning round. Broward, hello. Little Tom Jr. there. Dade County, hello.
Sandy Payton's a bitch.
That's the word around here, sir. Boca, hello.
This is Dr. Vance. Can I hold for J. Michaels?
Boy, since they let him out of the trunk, he's never been the same, has he? Broward, hello.
Yeah, this is Pat. Sandy, help me.
Broward, hello.
I'm dying over here.
Nice reading, sir.
That was shocking.
Nice
okay,
reading.
Boy, that was...
very impressive.
I'd hire him right away. Dade County, hello. That was good. You ran out of time, sir. Broward, hello.
Hey, sometimes you feel like a nook. Sometimes you don't.
Dade County, hello.
Picture yourself in a boat on a river with deadly dreams.
Boy, they are really. What happened? From yesterday to today, I guess they really woke up in a big way, didn't they?
Always.
Yesterday they were in a coma. Today they're doing a Mexican tap dance. It must have been the food from Peppers. Dade, hello.
Hello, listen. Tell me real quick. Who was the...
Palm Beach, hello.
Hello, Neil. Do you have my Wundermug?
Call from Winmore.
Wundermug.
Yeah, as in Vance.
Mm-hmm.
Broward, hello.
Hollywood guards are douchebags.
Dade County, hello.
Did he say the creamy Italian or the vinaigrette?
How do you like the levels on these buzzers? I'm going to put that in machine three. Number one is the levels on these things are all over the place. Dade County, hello.
Neil, you've really been buggering me.
My luck, I pressed one and I just put the thing in machine number three. Must be an omen about that, huh? Boca, hello.
I am the Boca Puker.
Well, thank God. We're getting pretty close to the end. A day without him would be like a day without heartburn.
Where's the dork lady?
Palm Beach, hello.
My name is Joe Martin. I love Dennis Dorsey.
Broward, hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Is this WIOD?
Oh, God. Slower than molasses. Dade County, hello.
This is Joe Provocateur. Any calls?
Joe Provocateur. Boca, hello. Boca.
Wally Doodle all day.
Yeah, we missed that again today. Can you believe it? 2 days in a row we missed out on Willie Nelson. One moment, please, if we can find it real quick. No wonder they sound a little bit distraught. Okay, probably the level will be real low.
Polly Wally Doodle all the day.
Okay, thank you. Broward, hello.
You know the difference between sugar apples and...
Yeah, that's Ed...
Junior.
Mm-hmm. Broward, hello.
Show sucks.
Get a radio show, pal.
That must have been Trembler Jr., wasn't it? Boca, hello.
Yes.
Dade County, hello.
It's horror.
Broward, hello.
Doctor, I've got the blue balls.
Dade County, hello.
Hey, it's MS time for Margaret.
Oh, what a couple of calls in a row. Kendall again. Out of control, boy. He must have that TV just smoking right now. Dade, I think I punched two at the same time. Dade County, hello.
Mitch Webster is an error provocateur.
That was Stuart Elliott.
Was
you recognize that voice?
Yeah.
No, I'm sorry,
another one
Stewart.
Of those broken down Cubs fans.
Yeah.
Broward, hello.
Get ready.
WNWS.
What was it?
It's W News, wasn't it?
No, I don't know. I couldn't make it out. Palm Beach, hello.
Okay, what's the question, sir? What's the question?
That was Larry King Jr. Dade County, hello.
And that's the way it was.
I wish I'd stop pressing number one there. There's nothing in the machine. What'll really be great is when the buzzer goes off and there's nothing in there. Broward, hello. Oh, that was Rush Limbaugh's number, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I think so. Dade County, hello.
Why is this ponderous?
Good one.
I think that was young Esther, wasn't it? That sounded just like Esther. When you're running again at Hialeah, Esther. Broward, hello.
Who is that man laughing in the background?
Palm Beach, hello.
But my ass is in a sling.
Broward, hello.
Neil, you're a dork.
Yeah. Oh, she didn't want to let you down.
Thank God.
Dade County, hello.
Miami Shores is full of rabid gerbils. Help me.
The Miami Shores Phantom there. Boy, we haven't heard that voice in a long time.
Yeah.
Dade County, hello.
If Sally and Jane Lovett and Susan Lixman would Dan rather.
And finally in Broward.
Hello.
Okay. Well, that's going to do it here on a wonderful Tuesday. This is sure a big pick-me-up from yesterday. Mm-hmm. Of course, so would death have been a big pick-me-up from yesterday. Okay, Steve has got a four-hour abortive show coming up. It's going to be something. I'm personally going to be listening to the Dion CD in the car, but you'll stick around for Steve. Sports Talk, Sonny and Joe, and Lou Gorman, GM of the Red Sox, Little Rush, Bing Bang, and Yankee Baseball, and then we'll take a poll tomorrow on which one is most depressing. Have a wonderful day. We'll see you tomorrow morning at 10.